New Peugeot 3008, prices, specs, and in-depth guide to the 2017 SUV. Everything you need to know about the new Peugeot 3008, its design, technology, testing, prices and specifications. Peugeot has launched its all-new 3008, a new SUV which steps away from the original 3008 model's MPV-inspired outlook and takes on the form of a stylish crossover, which will sit underneath the new 5008. In the run-up to the car's launch, Peugeot granted Auto Express exclusive access to the new 3008, then known simply by its codename of P8, for many months before anyone outside of the organization had seen it. Legal documents were signed and promises made, just so we could let you see some of the thinking behind what is a groundbreaking, and hugely important, new model for the company. On these pages we bring you a comprehensive in-depth guide to the new Peugeot 3008. We've spoken to the people who created it, followed it through the design and testing phases and explored its advanced technology in detail. Peugeot 3008, prices and specs. Prices for the Peugeot 3008 will kick off at £21,795 when it hits dealerships in January, making it noticeably more expensive than alternatives like the Nissan Qashqai and the newly released Seat Ateca. That's because Peugeot has decided to go practical and premium with its new crossover. The standard equipment list is huge across the range, and it's a slightly larger car with a bigger boot than many of its rivals, coming in at 520 liters. Cars in entry-level active trim benefit from a hefty infotainment suite, including a configurable 12.3-inch digital instrument display, as well as an 8-inch touchscreen with built-in Apple CarPlay and Mirror Link for Android smartphones. It forms the car's so-called iCockpit interior, the screen-laden center console and dashboard wrapping around and cocooning the driver. Dual climate control and rear parking sensors also come as standard on the entry-level model, alongside safety equipment such as automatic emergency braking, lane departure warning and distance alert. It sits on 17-inch alloy wheels, with automatic headlights and wipers thrown in. While standard kit on the entry-level model is extensive, Peugeot expects that more than 50% of customers will shell out a little more for a lure trim. Cars at this level start from £23,595, and pack additional safety and assistance tech, front and rear parking sensors, a reversing camera, partial leather effect interior, power folding mirrors with blind spot indicators, plus satellite navigation. They'll also get a raft of styling tweaks, setting the car apart from its entry-level sibling. Larger 18-inch alloy wheels are standard, as is the chrome detailing on the front wing, the gray scuff plate on the front bumper, and the stainless steel door sills. £25,495 GT line cars get some sporty design tweaks, including a different grille, a tweaked front bumper, black roof, a twin exhaust effect rear bumper, as well as LED headlamps, fog lamps and front indicators. The cabin gets a new look, and features a configurable iCockpit system. The range topper will be the 3008 GT. With a price tag of £32,995, it exclusively gets a 179 bhp 2.0-liter Blue Envy diesel engine mated to a 6-speed automatic gearbox. Fuel economy of 58.9 mpg is claimed. Full leather seats come as standard, while the driver's seat is 8-way adjustable with a multi-point massage function. There are more design tweaks such as the aluminium roof bars, 19-inch alloy wheels with wheel arch extensions, and a panoramic glass roof. Additional tech such as keyless entry / go, adaptive cruise control and an electric tailgate is also included. The new 3008 is built on a new platform called EMP2, which is an important part of Peugeot's plan to release 9 new models by 2021. The platform saves weight, which means that the 3008 is around 100 kilograms lighter than the outgoing model, lowering emissions and improving fuel economy. The turbocharged 1.2-liter PureTech 3-cylinder petrol engine will be the cheapest engine option on every model, with the exception of the GT. producing 129 bhp and 117 g/km CO2, Peugeot claims it'll be capable of 55.4 mpg on a combined run. It'll be available with a 6-speed manual or 6-speed automatic gearbox. Allure and GT line models will get a second petrol choice, a 163 bhp, 1.6-liter unit. CO2 goes up to 129 g/km, while economy dips to 48.7 mpg. Diesels will kick off with a 98 bhp, 1.6-liter option with a 5-speed manual for the active model only. It'll be the cleanest in the range with 103 g/km CO2 emissions, and the joint cheapest to run with claimed fuel economy of 70.4 mpg. A 118 bhp diesel will be available across the range and is the most ubiquitous engine choice. It can be had with a manual or automatic 6-speed gearbox, and Peugeot claims the same 70.4 mpg score for the manual version. GT line gets a unique engine choice in the form of a 148 bhp 2.0-liter diesel, and fuel economy comes in at 67.3 mpg. There are no hybrid or electric models from launch, but a plug-in hybrid version of the 3008 will arrive in 2019.